Let's take a quick look at the TCP beacon. Again, Cobalt Strike listeners, press add, and we will create a EC2 TCP beacon, beacon TCP. And this one I will bind to localhost only. Press save, and there we go. We now have our TCP beacon. One thing I like to do, or I anticipate I will like to do, it's a new feature, but one thing is for listeners that you expect have a specific purpose, consider giving them a color that indicates that it might be a different beacon from the others. For example, I'm going to flag this one as yellow, which is my way of indicating in the tool or to other operators that, hey, this is a localhost only beacon, just so that the operator doesn't miss that and try to use it for lateral movement. Okay, let's take a look at using the TCP beacon for something local. And I know what we'll do, that'll be kind of fun. Let's use the TCP beacon to create a session as another user. So what we're gonna do is right-click access, spawn as, and we're just gonna create a beacon running as the user. What a hog, why not? And she is a domain user on the domain corp. We're gonna hit dot, 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 and we will choose our TCP beacon. Hit choose, hit launch. And if all goes well, we will end up with a session as the user What a Hog linked through Jim Stevens. And again, remember that our egress is DNS here, so we're actually pushing the entire payload over DNS. And that's not necessary for this demo, but it's my way of making the demo take a lot more time. In fact, I do want to point something out that is very, very relevant. If we click on the toolbar, there are shortcuts here for different menus. This one right here is to go back to the sessions table. And I want to point out a column, and that's the listener column. The purpose of the listener column is to quickly let an operator know which beacon or which type of channel your chain of things is egressing through. Because if you have an HTTP beacon here and a DNS one, you really want to know which one is the parent of your beacons so you know the performance characteristics of that channel. So that's the listener column. And we can see that we did indeed get our What a Hog beacon. And if we click over here, we can see the pivot graph. And there's What a Hog. Another thing to point out, orange lines are the SMB beacon and teal lines are the TCP beacon. So that's what that looks like. So that's a little bit on the TCP beacon. I suppose real quick, I can show you linking and unlinking to it just to convince you that what I explained in the slides is real and works. So there we go, we've disconnected from it. And if we come over here, let's go ahead and connect to 127.0.0.1, port 4444, and there we go. We've resumed control of this TCP beacon from another access. So that's what I wanted to show you with the TCP beacon.